Hello, today we will try to make an AI that will be able to detect resistors, and for this we need to label these images. So the idea was to do it for other parts as well, but for now we will stick to resistors because it's time-consuming. For this we go to this website, Make Sense AI Drop Images. First I have a folder here. This is my second attempt. Copy these to here, maybe images up. Second attempt, and then up, drag and drop. Detection labels, just SMD res. And through hole res. Now so let's start. Delete this one. Let's zoom in up, and I don't want bounding box, I want polygons. Up, up, up. Okay, so I just need to go through this very fast. I mean, as you see, this will not be very fast because it's a very much time consuming. In the end, I changed my solution, so I will just use, I will make a mask. So the first step is to make a mask, so I just paint over the resistors, and then I will use a script to convert this to the correct format, which I already did in the past. Let's see how this goes. Okay, let's try to do this. So I will do this live with you. I'm not sure about the result, but let's see. We need the black background here. As far as I know, and if I remember correctly, if we want multiple labels, what's this? If we want multiple labels, we just need multiple colors, so multiple shades of gray. Okay, this seems to work, seems to be fair. Then we need to close this. Oh, it's this point here. this one should be here. Okay, let's do this for the first image. So the first thing is to export file, export as a JPEG, 100% save. Okay, now I need to copy this. Here. Okay. Now I need to get the software, and for this we will go Ross Agriculture GitHub, and then I wrote a small program for this. I just needed this one, synthetic data. So I wrote this, so I should be able to reuse it easily. I used PyCoco Creator, which is not mine. It's from Waspinator. That, as you see here, allows you to go from this to a mask here, a coco mask. So just download this. Up, second attempt. Yes, open. This takes a long time because I guess we also have the neural network. We need, I think, only this one. I'm not sure. Train. Cool. Up. Up, okay, I think it's this one we need. Shape to coco, it's definitely what we need to run. Annotations, okay, I remember, how was it working again? I think this first number is the serial number, so this is, I will delete all of these, delete. And here we'll have the real file, delete. And here I think is the JSON, the generated JSON file. So let's put in here, let's put second attempt. Images, let's put this one in here. In annotations, let's put the mask, and then let's go here and edit this file. I want, oula, what's happening with Krita here? Okay. So, okay, the folders are right. License, category, name. I want to change this. Resistor super category of ID1. So filter for JPEGs, filter. So I really want to thank the author of this really useful tool for their work and for sharing it. Filter for JPEG, go through each image, filter for... Oh, we need a PNG associated, okay. Okay, I remember how this was. Annotation. Image ID, object class name, and annotation ID. And here just image ID. Okay. So in here it should be named image ID. Underscore object class name, I think resistor SMD, and then annotation ID, which is, let's just reopen this bit and 01. Where is 0, register SMD 0, rename. I'll just check that this resistor and then big SMD is the same as here, resistor and big SMD. Segmentation ID 1. Okay, line 90 and 91. Okay, and then if, do we have this? If square. X. Dot name, where is this X? try. No, I don't want to save. Let's leave this here for now. I need a PNG, so I will go back to here, file, export, PNG, save, save. I'm just afraid that a library will be missing or something like this. Image label in second attempt, synthetic data here, open in a terminal, Python. No module named by coco create tools. This was to be expected. Okay, I'll just use this environment. Oh, why did I see? And then image labeling, and then second attempt, and then synthetic data, and then step 3, make it box. Okay. So this should clone the Git repo. Okay, cool. Still no module named. Do we need to clone this? Successfully built by coco tools. Why is it not working then? This does work. No module named Py Coco create tools. Maybe this should be replaced by coco tools. No module named by coco tools. I know there is a module named by coco tools. Okay, we will just by coco create tools. Let's read. Okay, I might have an idea. We need to copy the two files that are in Py Coco Creator. Py Coco Creator tools, and then we'll copy the init to where we are, and we will copy the other one by coco create tools. I think now it should work. Creator. Let's check this. Why can it not import name? Okay, I know. I know. Of course. So we remove py coco creator tools from here. We will remove the init. And now if we go, if we copy the py coco creator tools to where we are and here recurrently, now we should have py coco creator tools, and now it should hopefully work. Yes, it did work. So it was going into the folder py coco creator tools and trying to load the file. Now it generated the new JSON file. Let's check it. First we'll just, so this one's useful. This one's not useful. Let's check it. ID 1, huh, still plant, name bit, it didn't change, okay, first, we have a problem here, because we want this to be 0, then we want this to be resistor SMD, no, one word, and then we want this to be 0 again. Vim shape. Did I save it on the other one? Yes, I guess so. Seems like I didn't. Sorry, resistor SMD. ID 1. To have ID 1 here. Not sure. Let's save this relaunch. Invalid syntax. Line 42. resistor SMD, perfect. Annotations. Let's see. Now let's use this. For this we will go anaconda. Yes, I would like to anaconda navigator. Create a new environment. I need to install. Okay, I will install it. Installed, and now just want to launch. Where are we? Yes, perfect. Image label in second attempt, synthetic 3, visualize. Let's hope that no module named. Which one is it? By Coco Tools. I think we can install it like this. Perfect, successfully installed by Coco Tools. Perfect, everything was imported up. Name of category resistor SMD. Example. Dot coco get image ID. Where do they get them? Yes, this one's right. Where is this one defined? Here, in annotation file. Okay. Get categories ID. When we what happens when we just print this one? Okay, this works. And then image IDs equals. This one works as well. And then let's print image IDs. It's empty. Why is it empty? where is it here? Image IDs. ID, it does have one. Oh, it does work with this? What? Why? There is something I'm missing. Okay, so we've got this one right. And then what happens this step? I guess if it's empty, that's not no good news. Cat IDs. Okay, we got this one, cat IDs and image IDs. Cat IDs, and we gave it resistor SMD. Where is it? Cat IDs, and we gave it the name. Now, image name 0. 0.jpg. I think I know. It's because this file should be a 0. Let's reload this. Oh no, I don't need this one anymore. Still empty? I need to reload this file. Categories ID. resistors MD image ID equals 1. File name 0.jpg. Category IDs is one. So we are looking for a one here. Category IDs equals 1. Why is it? Okay, for whatever reason it, but that's not good, is it? It doesn't give it the right image ID. Yes, the file name, so it's somewhere 0.jpg ID 1 ID 1 ID 1. Can we see something here? No, it's not annotated. Yes, annotations 0. There is nothing in the annotation part. Why is it this way? Categories name. We did this. This is a JPEG. I don't want a JPEG. Way better. Okay, this looks way better. What was in here? Forgot. Can we go back? Oh, now it's working. Perfect. Great. Okay, this is working. Now, what do we need to do next? We need to do this for the other pictures. So I just delete these. Yes, okay. Let's do this. Okay, let's do this. I'll just start so you can see how I work, and then up. So I need to take a good sized brush, then I will just go with white, maybe zoom in a bit. Okay, I was on the was using the eraser. Up, 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 space to move. This goes very fast. Sometimes it's not done perfectly. You can always erase something very easily. As I said before, can always have multiple labels. Okay, this one's good. So I need to export it as a PNG, save, come here. I need to rename this one to 1. We will rename it once again. I closed the file. I shouldn't have done this. Oh no, this one. No, of course this is the we need a black background. Is there a way to paint everything in black? And now we need to export it. Save. Now I need to copy this to here. Let's run the script a second time. Why did it run only once? Okay, it's because of this. I think I can. Oh. I need to export this as a JPEG. Perfect. This one works very well, but if you look at it, I don't know if it's on purpose, but the color ID changes every time. Will it never change? now just need to do it for all the other images. So the first thing I will do to make it easier is to copy the other images. This one and this one. Wrong folder, and now I can open to and blah, these pictures. I don't know if the quality will be, if we have enough data. Because these are just a few images up. Okay, so I just found out that here I should have a random number, but I can force it to show which image I want it to work with. And I just checked that I had one category ID. I remove this one, we don't need this one. And I think I changed here this part. So if I put here 2 and relaunch the script, it should give me 2 here. I'm not sure though. No, I don't know. I'm not sure. No. It's because in the other program, I only have defined 1. In the program, in this script, I've only defined 1, but I think the right way to go is to here for, so these are resistors, SMD resistors, so I should always, or maybe not, I don't know. Okay, so it's done for the fourth file. I will try with only 4 files to see how this goes. Work the same. Now let's go 3. Perfect. Yeah, out of range. So probably the 0th. No, the 1st. No, it's the 2nd. Is it? Yes. Okay, that's perfect. That is very, very nice. And now I need to reconnect to this one. Wait for it to reconnect. Okay, now what's this? It's downloading whatever it needs. Installs detectron. Okay, we will restart the runtime here. Train. Okay, so let's copy these into the JPEG images folder. And the annotations. Okay, let's do this. You know what? I'll just drag and drop this. Yes. And then for the other pictures, I can just, since I would have zipped them if we had multiple ones, but since we only have four, I can drag and drop them one by one. Can I drag and drop multiple files same time? Yes. Okay, maybe in the end I wouldn't have done it. Now restart. Yes. Perfect. We need to import whatever we need. Now here we need to change this to this up. We need to change this to this up train. I really don't know if four images will do the trick, but since we have multiple small parts in the image, I thought that this might work. This is downloading the pre-trained neural network. It's not training yet. I think we will skip this. We'll just do this one. We need to change this one to... I think we just need to remove this. I will get you back as soon as this is over. Okay, so it's done. It doesn't look so bad, at least this, the total loss reduced. Let's see. Yeah, I don't know if this one's useful. Just want to go to this one. Name predictors not defined. And up. I hope this will work. Finger crossed. Why is it taking so long? And oh no. Oh, it didn't have enough data to produce anything meaningful, because look, it just predicted the whole box, but that's not what I wanted. Okay, same thing around here. So it doesn't work very well. Actually, it doesn't work at all. I have to retest it with more images and four. Try something like 2000, but 2000 will take forever. generate. Okay, let's see. Thank you for watching though.